Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for joining this web conference about the integrated eChassis module, one of Benteler's solutions for the future of electric mobility. My name is Ivo Strovsky, and I'm heading communications and marketing at Benteler Automotive, and I have the honor to moderate this event. You all know mobility will be electric, but building an electric vehicle is not as easy as it seems. This applies especially to the chassis. An electrified drive system entails an enormous complexity of development. The requirements for an electrified chassis system differ fundamentally from those for vehicles with combustion engines, be it in terms of driving behavior, NVH, or the challenge of optimally designing the interface between the chassis and the electric motor with up to 300 kilowatts of power. We have therefore made it our business to find a simple solution for the demanding development of an electrified chassis system. Fast, efficient, reliable. We have founded, and Marco Kohlmeier, our Vice President of the Business Unit E-Mobility, and Ulrich Hammelmeier, Program Manager and Senior Engineer, are happy to share it with you. Before we start, I would like to inform you about two important items. First, we use Microsoft Teams for the web conference, a service provided by the Microsoft Corporation based in the USA. The data is stored on servers in the European Union, but the possibility of transferring analysis data to a third country cannot be excluded. By participating in the web conference, you agree to the processing of your personal data by the Benteler Group. Information on the user as well as technical data are recorded. In case of dial-in via telephone, the incoming and outgoing telephone number and the duration of participation are also stored. We will record this web conference and may publish it on our internal or external communication channels. Second, you have the possibility to use the chat function during the web conference in order to ask questions. We gather these questions and Marco will answer them after his presentations together with Ulrich. Chat questions, once entered, cannot be seen by you or other participants. We encourage you to ask questions. This web conference relies on your questions. Now, it only remains for me to wish you much joy and excitement for this web conference. Marco, Ulrich, the virtual stage is yours.
Thank you, Yves. Good evening to our European listeners and good morning to our guests from North and South America or Canada. And of course, good night to our late night fans probably in Asia. My name is Marco Kohlmeier. I'm the Vice President of our Global Business Unit E-Mobility at Benteler Automotive. As it is difficult in these times to get in contact personally, we went for this viral presentation. Thank you for your numerous joining. That gives us the confirmation that we have touched an interesting topic of e-mobility. Before we start, please welcome also my colleague Ulrich Hammelmeier. Ulrich, please introduce yourself.
Thank you, Marco. As already mentioned, my name is Ulrich Hammelmeier and I'm in the position of a program manager inside the business unit e-mobility. I joined Benteler Automotive nearly 20 years ago and run through different positions within the business unit chassis. I've been some years in the production of chassis modules and components. During this time, I gather plenty of valuable experience. Before my move to the business unit e-mobility, I was responsible for the worldwide system integration team for chassis modules. Today, I'm glad to be part of this conference and hand over now back to Marco.
Thank you, Ulrich. This webinar is structured in four steps. First, I would like to introduce very shortly our company, Benteler. Then I will give you a full picture of our Benteler platform approach and the integrated eChassis module. After that, Ulrich will take you on a deep dive of the process and the results of the integrated eChassis module development. We like to end with a Q&A session. So let's start. Benteler is a family-owned company since more than 140 years, and therefore a very rare entity in these times. With the sales of 7.7 billion last year, we are one of the top 50 automotive suppliers. We are in 28 countries with 100 locations. We are there where the customer is. 30,000 employees are joining our team, and we are working in two divisions. The biggest one is the automotive division with 86% of the turnover, and the other one is the steel tube business with 14% of our turnover. As mentioned, Benteler Automotive is a top 50 tier one supplier in the automotive world, with a global footprint in 25 countries with more than 70 plants. With our portfolio, we are quite independent from the kind of powertrain is used. 85% of our portfolio you can find in combustion cars and in electric vehicles. We are experts in chassis and chassis modules. We are, since long time, expert in structural parts, especially on high strength and ultra high strength steel and lightweight solutions, relevant for, of course, weight management and crash management solution. With our engine and exhaust systems business unit, we take care about the periphery of the powertrain. Our new founded business unit, Electromobility, founded in 2017, is taking care of system solutions for the new electric vehicle market. And some smaller units is our mechanical engineering unit, which takes care about tooling, which means we are able to make our own manufacturing tools. And another smaller group is the lightweight protection, which is about ballistic steels for the private sector, of course, not for the military application. That's why we call us the core of the vehicle. You can find our products nearly in every car which is running on the road. Seeing this picture, you can understand why we have taken the decision to set up a platform solution for e-mobility application. Why? Because we can, and we have nearly all the products. This leads to an increased portfolio for the e-mobility market. We call ourselves in this region a full system supplier because we offer for our systems the full system engineering. We are making the mules and prototypes in-house in our prototype shop. We support the customer with industrialization support in case he wants to manufacture the parts and systems on his own. And we also can deliver the parts while doing manufacturing with our partners or in one of our plants. And of course, to give the customer freedom to operate, you can also receive a license of our systems to manufacture totally on your own. The Benteler electric drive system is deducted from our maybe well-known rolling chassis, which is actually in the media and in the on YouTube. It is developed together with our partner Bosch. From this rolling chassis, we deduct the BETS platform for passenger cars and people mover. And even on a lower level, on a module level, we offer battery packs and the product we want to talk about now, our integrated e-chassis module. So let's highlight this integrated e-chassis module. With our platform approach, together with Bosch, we have developed a modular and scalable platform. What does it mean, modular and scalable? Modular in the kind of taking over designs which have not to be customized while changing parametrics of the car. Scalable while being able to change parametrics, for example, in the wheelbase, or in the vehicle width, or in the track width of the chassis, without big engineering efforts to change everything. The platform in detail, we have front chassis modules up to 200 kilowatt electric power, of course with the power electronic, same for the rear chassis module. The EDUs, the electric drive units, are NVH optimized by the EDU mounts. We integrate steering and braking besides the electric motor. We have a 400 volt water and glycol cooled battery pack, and we have charging AC-DC integrated, the low voltage routing and the high voltage routing. And with our partner Bosch, we can also offer steering units like the VCU, the PDU, the DC-DC changer, and the MCU, and even more, too much to count here. What does it lead for, what does it lead to? Together with our partner, we can offer the best mechanical integration, and this is even more than only a packaging, because together we can optimize the interfaces of the mechanical components and systems and the electrical systems. This leads to a best functionality of the platform. Do we have the proof point? Yes. It is in our Bosch Benteler Rolling Chassis 2.1, which you can see on YouTube actually driving on the famous Boxberg and outperforming the competition. Modularity is often used keyword in engineering, but very difficult to achieve. This is our solution. It is like a construction kit covering a defined system and defining the system limits for scalability. The core is the BEDS platform. There we deduct our modules for the front e-chassis, for the rear e-chassis module and the battery pack. And of course, you can upgrade the platform to a full rolling chassis while choosing a flex frame for a body on frame architecture, or even a normal steel underbody for a unibody architecture. Here you see now our e-chassis portfolio. That's why we are talking about plural solutions. We have several solutions for the DEF segment, a multi-link front suspension and a multi-link rear suspension. For the smaller segments, B2C, we have an E-MacPherson front suspension, we have a twist beam solution for the rear, and also a tie blade solution, not shown here. The modularity of the chassis modules is achieved by the profile length among new longitudinal and lateral direction. You can order the chassis in aluminum or steel. We have isolated body mounts, 4 to 6 point. We have an isolated 3-point EDU mount to the subframe. And with our partner Vibracoustic, each subframe and each chassis is optimized from an NVH standpoint with an excellent rubber bush concept. Of course, we also offer air springs as an option, and together with our partner Bosch, we have a proven data setup for fast functional integration into the MCU and the VCU. We call it pre-integrated solution. Pre-integration is only possible with partners. On the picture, you see the roles and responsibilities of the three-party partnership on our e-chassis. And it shows also that without a strong partnership, these kind of system solutions are not implementable in the market. So Benteler is responsible for the full system development and the full mechanical integration of all components, as well as the driving dynamics and the driving safety. Bosch provides the electric drive unit called the Bosch E-Axle in different versions, and of course the steering system. Vibracoustic, as mentioned, takes care about all the NVH relevant rubber bushings in the whole e-chassis system, and you see on the picture, these are quite a lot. So what are we doing from Benteler's side? We I have a clear definition of requirement manuals with the customers. We do the mechanical integration. We have a validated interface design, and we are able to react fast to change requirements with minimal efforts. System development or a system is not the sum of its parts. With our visual BOM, you can see here, you see the complexity of all the components, and there are still some left. We cut it out, the C parts here. As an example, you see how difficult system integration and interface optimization can be. For example, the integration of the electric drive unit into the subframe is a big interface development job, taking care about the mounts and the rubber bushings to optimize the NVH behavior. Because you know, the EDU turns 16,000 to 20,000 RPM in this chassis, and this can lead that this e-chassis is moving towards a kind of a loudspeaker. Second example is the integration of the steering, because normally it's packaged there where the EDU is, and now there is the EDU, and now you have to find a very good position and keep the vehicle dynamics, and this is not that easy. And all the other integration of the part to keep the best functionality, and of course, beside to achieve a valuable and payable design. Pre-integration means also having the system pre-validated and tested and clearly specified. With this table, you see two examples of the pre-validated, pre-integrated, and pre-specified solutions of our e-chassis. I will not go all through this table, but you can see we have a clear defined system limits of our e-chassis, which you can take as comparison to your target book or even adjust your target book, because playing in these system limits affords less or no engineering change on the e-chassis module. And that leads to real savings in the development cost. What about the modularity of the chassis itself? I mentioned it about the scalable frame, but we all know there is no standard chassis in the market. There is always customizing. What are we doing? We keep the functional hard points of the chassis fixed. That means, independent if you change your wheel size, ground clearance, track width, your axle load, steering wheel position, we can handle this with no or less engineering changes, while we keep the functional hardpoint frame of our chassis. So it's really no effort to lengthen a little bit the link arm or to give the subframe a different shape, as long as you keep this functional point. On the left, you see our assessment on this, and I know you can read this table, but it's just to show you what we have done. You see changing parametrics on the left, and you see the impact. If there is a green color, you see changing track width in a defined area does not lead to any engineering change in the product or in the function. Having less yellow colors, you see we have a small engineering effort, and the orange one is a change in the parametrics which lead to a higher engineering effort, but at any time less than starting totally from scratch. So, and that is important, although having the modular chassis, no customer gets the same chassis because it's the kind of module. So with the tuning and the vehicle, I would say data, every driving dynamics is different towards the chassis and with your car. But the functional performance remains always the same, although we have this variability. As I mentioned, minor modifications to hardware do not really impact the system interfaces and the package. There we take care for. And from the functional integration side, we have well-prepared software-based applications together with our partner Bosch, including service options for customizing up to the turnkey application, which really reduce the engineering effort. How have we achieved this? You know, system development is totally different than component development. We are starting from the functional approach, from top to bottom, which means we define the kinematics and the compliance, NVH behavior, package durability, and so on, and then deduct clear requirements and specifications for the components. And of course, dealing with this complexity affords a holistic program management, being able to steer all the partners joining this chassis development. But this is only at a glance, because Ulrich will in some minutes show you even more how this methodology and this development process has worked on our integrated e-chassis modules. But the message is, you can only achieve it with a partner, because solving interface problems means that every partner can change his component for the better functionality. And this is only working in an excellent partnership area. Together with Bosch and Vibracoustic, we achieved this excellent working together. So how is that materialized? And you see this in a significant reduction of development efforts and of course of time, because we do not start from scratch. So what do you receive while taking an integrated e-chassis module? You start with predefined documents from the program management, existing RASi chart, boundary diagram for the whole engineering services. And you don't have to take care of the numerous interfaces of the e-chassis, because we have reduced it. In the e-chassis module, the partners and Benteler have cleared up these interfaces and solved this open issue. And they don't need to be specified externally. Extra. We have an aligned supplier network, which means the industrialization is very fast applicable, because all our suppliers know the e-chassis module and have the parts approved from us as the system integrator and can deliver. The pre-validated functions and components derived from simulations and testing and from the BETS prototype experience. Tuning, as I mentioned, can be done very fast because we have a profound expertise on that, and we have the availability of the related hardware, because we can do everything in-house with our partners, one-stop shop. That means also we have all the testing capabilities in the house, and Ulrich will show you what that means, because he has some very nice slides about that. So, and beside, we have also great synergies, because we are not testing every component on its own. We can combine the testing on a system level, and that reduces also the cost. How do we know? We know because we have done it already. We have done it in several customer projects where we set up on basis of our modular solutions prototype vehicles. And of course, we have built together with our partners our BETS 2.1, which looks like a dune buggy, which you see on YouTube. And of course, this is a pre-look. We will have also a full car based on our Bosch Benteler rolling chassis, where you can also drive in a real vehicle condition the performance of this platform and, of course, of the integrated e-chassis module. So now, Ulrich will take you on a very nice journey of the development of the EIM, and I will hand over to Ulrich.
Thank you very much, Marco. In the next 30 minutes, I will give you an overview regarding the functions, methods and tools we are using by Bentler for the developing of the integrated eChassis module. I know that this is a huge content for the short time, but I will try my best to give you the important points here. And to do so, we will focus on four different topics. This is the first one, the topology development. The second one, the NVH. The third one, the component development, which also includes the development of our Bentler own components. And last but not least, the system integration. Starting with the topology development, we understand the topology development as a sum of several disciplines. You see here on the different tiles that we have a kind of benchmark, subjective and objective evaluation, target setting for DNA, for KNC targets, but also the products directly also part of the topology development inside our development process. And this is very important because this differs us from our competitors, because the characteristics from the components, especially the strengths and the material behaviors, give us a huge impact on the compliance and kinematics. So I will show you on the next slide. For the benchmark, we generally can split this in two different departments. The one is the paper-based on the left side, what you can see here. And the second one on the right side is an experimental benchmark. Coming to the left side, and there we see a table which is coming out of big databases, which gives us interesting information about full vehicles in terms of the suspension concepts, the weight, dimensions, and kind of powertrain they are using. But also information about the position of the steering, the position of the EDU, and the interface technologies which are using. Also very interesting is the part of the weight distribution. This is something is especially for the electrical vehicles topic, which we always discussed also internally, very emotional, because we always try to make a really balanced situation for the complete car. Also, we do a lot of benchmark regarding the suspension fingerprint or KNCs for different suspension. This is something very interesting for us because there we can gain a lot of interesting information out of it to get to good recommendations for our customer what is the correct direction to development topology of the car and to set the correct targets in the beginning of a program. On the right side, you see, I already mentioned this, the experimental part of the benchmark. There we split in the subjective and the objective benchmark of cars. This is very important because both the measurement and also the own impression gives us a lot of hints to the development and for the target setting. On the next slide, you can see how we do this for the subjective evaluation. Let me start on the right side of this sheet. There you can see that we develop our own structure, how to develop and how to evaluate actually the subjective impressions, because every driver actually has some other experience, some other expectations when you are starting the first time with a new suspension concept or a new car. And so we try to bring this in sequence and also in the structure so that the person itself is as good as possible out of the scope and really that we're concentrating on the single topics. Actually, we are looking for 40 different maneuvers for the vehicle dynamics and 21 which are only related to NVH and to the comfort. In the middle, you can see one section is called the braking response as an example here, how these cheats are looking like. In the very beginning, the maneuver, what we are running, is described. Here it's a straight ahead stability of braking. Then in the second column, we describe a little bit what this kind of maneuver is, and then directly the rating from 1 to 10 is given by the driver. And in this case, we had two different vehicles to evaluate, and so you see different numbers there in the columns. We do all these evaluations with an empty vehicle and with a full-loaded vehicle. Of course, empty vehicle means there's a driver inside and some special loads in the trunk and on the back seat, so that is a defined position of the car. At the end, the drivers have a chance to give some comments in the columns, and so we come to a good evaluation overall. This subjective evaluation is done on the one hand on proving grounds, of course, with really clear defined road surfaces and also defined roads. And on the other side, we are doing this on public roads because some events are only existing really in the public roads and not on proving grounds. And therefore, for example, we had here one Paderborn circus evaluated a couple of years ago, where we can drive this benchmark cars or also with our own suspension developments to give us a first impression. We are really fast because this is a known route from everybody. And also we are using this circus for the management appraisers to show them where we are working on and what are the difference to the other suspensions. On this slide, we just show some kinds of testing experience we already gained in the last years. You can see on the right side that we were at a lot of different proving grounds around the world. Of course, in Germany, here it's a Boxberg from Bosch, or in Papenburg, it's from ATP, this proving ground, but also in Belgium from Ford, and there were several visits in the US by Ford and by other OEMs. And of course, also in China, we are on a regular basis on proving grounds to show the customers there our cars. It's very important because it's a subjective evaluation that we have not only one or two drivers, there are several drivers which are well trained to do this evaluation, which are familiar with our evaluation sheets, and so that we really get a stable information out of this benchmarks from the colleagues. On the next page, you can see our methodology for the objective evaluation. There we have also this kind of standard form developed, but this is much more easier because in the CDA, for example, in the standardization, there are a lot of maneuvers already mentioned, which are used also by us, like a steady state cornering or one center handling wave test and transition test, and so on. So what we are doing here is we are using the tests which are well known in the automotive. We are using also, according to the DIN 70,000, the same descriptions for the variables. We are using the same coordinate system, and also the post-processing of all our data comes to a grade that you can see on one sheet directly for one maneuver. What are the differences between the angle, the steering moment, the yaw rate, and so on, so that all the interesting information for one maneuver are on one page. We are doing this with the preparation of the vehicles with a lot of different devices. Here we show only, for example, the steering wheel, the measurement steering wheel. For the NVH development, we are using a lot of acceleration sensors and also some features from head acoustic to get interior impression from the sound. And for all these different applications, they are running about amplifier to store the data and on the laptops and to do the post-processing in this networks or MATLAB. On this slide, you actually see then all the findings we had out of the benchmark where we are processing this information in our simulation tools. Usually we start with ADAMS model, it's a multi-body simulation tool which rigid elements to event the first topology of the suspension, and directly goes on the very right side to the topology development to the directly into the CAD, so that you really have the first idea if the development of the topology is also feasible in the CAD in terms of package and also in terms of all the movement the wheel has to do during bounce and rebound. So that is actually a kind of target value search what we are doing there, because sometimes the CAD colleagues tell us we have to move for our package one link 2 or 3 millimeters in X direction, and then we can bring this directly back into our simulation to get better impressions. On the left downside, you see the KNC characteristics. This comes then out of our benchmark on the module level, what we are thinking what the correct KNC targets, or we got from our customers. So then we go with this KNC information in our Adams model and in our topology for the CAD model, and try to combine everything in the best solution we can find. To do so, we can see it in the middle. We have designed a kind of software called Heats that brings us a DOE at the end, that every movement of a kinematic point on the in the CAD is directly changed to the Adams models. And if you want to know what are really the biggest influence there, and then you can run this DOE, and this brings in results that the biggest influence or the lowest influence of this kinematic movement has the impact actually on the complete topology, or on the other side on the package. Never at the end we try to bring also all our stiffness into this Adams model. It's the first step is to bring the component stiffness inside. The second step is then to do real flex bodies inside the model, and also of course elastokinematics for the spring dampers and all the rubber bushings. Especially the rubber bushings, you all know this, have a lot of variation inside the mass production. There we are talking about 10 to 15% variation of the stiffness during the mass production, and this is something we also consider here into the models to come to the goal that we have a really robust vehicle engineering and vehicle dynamics at the end of the simulation for our models. What you see here, that's a very important point for our topology development, are the single components. I already mentioned that we bring them into the multi-body simulation as a flex body, and to do so, in the first step, we start for our components to select actually a design which fits to the functions we need in this suspension concept, and then we choose material concepts. We are choosing the stiffness what we need, and we calculate the strength and stress for this component. And of course, we look to the design and process estimates directly in this development phase, in this early stage actually, to get the feedback very fast if this what we are, the design what we think is the best for this topology really fits also then for the prototypes and for the mass production. Last but not least, is this one of the main topics what we try to achieve during this early stage, that all the designs for the single components we developed here are also directly capable for the mass production, and that they are not only as an engineering scope, that it's really a scope that wants to go to the SOP. All the component characteristics, actually, I mentioned this flowing back to the analytic tools like the Adams, and based on this, we can then set up multi-body simulation, and we are going up to the full car simulation in two different tools. The one is in We Are Great as a software, the other software is an ASM, as a full vehicle simulation tools, what we are feeding with our Adams models. And then you can see it on the right side on the small film. We can bring this into this car simulator and run our suspension systems even before we build up the first prototype. That gives us a complete feedback out of this real feeling from driving this simulator, and we really close the circle from the development and from the simulation side. It's important for us to get to this correlation really from the first sketch up to the full vehicles. Now we are coming to a second important topic, the NVH development. The NVH development, it's very, very important for us here in this stage, because the NVH is totally different for the e-chassis than we are used from our combustion engines. Combustion engines have the big advantage that they overlap a lot of noise coming out of the suspension, coming out of the road, what we never hear in our cars, because the combustion engine and the vibration we had there overlapping and everything. Right now, the one challenge we have is that the electric